Lord said, I think thoughts of peace and not of affliction. You will call upon me and I will answer you. And I will lead your captives from every place. Welcome to St. John's and the Beloved Disciple Church. We also greet those watching this Mass from their homes. Jesus offers this parable. Three servants are given huge sums of money. One gets 5 talents, another 2, and the third 1. They were to invest this money and make more. When the master returned, he called them in to see how they had done. 2 had doubled their sums. The third had done nothing. 2 were rewarded by their master, but 1 was thrown into darkness outside. Why did this happen? What warning does this give us?
Gather together to ask the Lord's blessing. He chastens and hastens his will to make known. The wicked oppressing now cease from distressing. Sing praises to his name. He forgets not his own. Beside us to guide us, our God with us joining, whose kingdom calls all to the love which endures. So from the beginning, the fight we were winning, you, Lord, were at our side.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess.
For my sweet God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Glory to God, glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Your wife shall be like a vine in the recesses of your home, your children like olive plants Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come, like a thief at night. When people are saying peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, for that day to overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the man who received 1 went off and dug a hole in the ground and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing the additional 5. He said, Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come share your master's joy. Then the one who had received 2 talents also came forward and said, Master, you gave me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more. His master said to him, Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come share your master's joy. Then the one who received the 1 talent came forward and said, Master, I knew you were a demanding person, harvesting where you did not plant and gathering where you did not scatter. So out of fear, I went off and buried your talent in the ground. Here it is back. His master said to him in reply, "You wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I did not plant and gather where I did not scatter. Should you not then have put my money in the bank so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given and he will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, my name is Father Tom Keller. I'm the pastor over at Assumption on Mattis Road. I'm happy to be here pinch hitting while Father's in the COVID gulag here for the next week. Apparently he's not ill in any way, but he lives with a priest who did come down with COVID, and I'm sure you know that. So anyway, he's got himself into a little pickle there and can't get out until the St. Louis County Health Department tells him he can go. So until then, I'm happy to be here with you this evening. The gospel today about the talents provide us with maybe two powerful phrases that are identified with entering into heaven. One is, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." The other one is, "Come share your master's joy." There's a couple of different servants we heard from in the parable. One didn't do very well, and then the other two did. The servant who showed himself to be responsible with his duties is the one, or the two of them, that are the faithful, the good and faithful servants who come to share their master's joy. They do so because they were diligent, diligent with what they were given. Those two phrases, though, is it not what we would like to hear said of us at the end of our life, when we go and stand before God? "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Come, share your master's joy." Obviously, we know that one servant is driven outside into the darkness. We don't want to be that guy. The servant who received the 5 talents, right? 5 talents. What is a talent? Well, it's one of those kind of things you have to look up on the internet, right? And even then, you're not 100% sure you get the right answer. A talent, I was told in the seminary, was almost a year's worth salary. And I've heard some people say it's a lifetime of earnings. You can look it up, and some people will say it's a talent is 100 pounds of gold. It's hard to say, but we know it's a large sum of money, right? It's a lot of money. And this guy, he invests it and somehow makes 5 more for his master. He doubles what was given to him as a responsibility. What responsibilities has God given you? What special gifts has God made you the steward of? Like these talents, each one of us are given gifts to be stewards of. Do we put those in the service of the Master? Do we allow those things that God has given us to grow in a way that will please God? I think of maybe parents who are given the gift of children. Instead of maybe raising those children to make you proud in earthly ways, have you helped them grow in religious virtues so that they too will serve God? I think of individuals who may be blessed financially, who may share their earthly wealth with others, especially the poor. Or I think of persons who have other special skills and abilities who can benefit the parish or the larger church through those gifts. Sometimes I think maybe of teachers or musicians or people with special compassion or organizational skills. But anything can be put to further the kingdom of God if it's a gift that God has given us. Back in my own parish, there was a woman who put God first in her life. When I got to know her, she was already in her 80s, but she's very revered. She was very revered in the parish, and she operated our parish library, which had on a regular basis an exact number of zero visitors. But she kept that library in good order in the hope that somebody would discover it. She had been, many years before, in charge of our parish school of religion, our PSR program. She'd been a religion teacher in the day school, and of course she was a mom and a grandmother. And today her children still volunteer in their parishes. One of her own children has been a volunteer in my parish for over 50 years, so she's got a legacy, I guess we could say, of putting her gifts in God's hands. The time of her funeral, and I've been to many funerals and even funerals of school teachers, former school teachers, retired school teachers, but I thought it was unusual because she did have so many former students come to the wake and to the funeral to talk about how they were affected by her. One could easily say that she heard those words, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." We pray our Lord also invited her to come and share her master's joy. Today, the parable of the talents offers us hope and encouragement that we can take the many blessings that God has given us and put them to his service. We return to the Lord not only the good things that he has given us, but those things that we have put to good use, those things that we have shared with others, those things that we have developed and grown for his service and the service of his kingdom. So at the end of our own lives, we will hear him say, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Come share your master's joy."
Thank you.
the leaders of our nation, state, and local communities, we pray to the Lord. For those who care for the elderly and disabled, we pray to the Lord. For food for the hungry, comfort for the disturbed, and safety for the homeless and refugees, we pray to the Lord. For those in hospice care and those who watch and wait with them, we pray to the Lord. For first responders and health care providers, we pray to the Lord. For our parish prayer intentions, we pray to the Lord. For all gathered in worship and for the intention of this Mass, especially the deceased members of the Jordan family, we pray to the Lord. For the sick and suffering, especially Randy Rickerman, Charles Schulin, Bill Schwab, Jean Schwartz, Barb Shaw, Clarence Smith, and Wilbert Swaller, we pray to the Lord. For those listed in our book of remembrance and all the poor souls, we pray to the Lord.
God, your Son is present in our daily lives. Help us to be ready when he returns. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
In the day of the Lord, the sun will shine like the dawn of eternal day. All creation will rise to dance and sing the glory of the Lord. And on that day will justice triumph. On that day will all be free, free from want, free from fear, free to live. In the day of the Lord, the sun will shine like the dawn of eternal day. All creation will rise to dance and sing the glory of the Lord. Then shall the nations throng together to the mountain of the Lord. They shall walk in the light of the Lord. In the day of the Lord, the sun will shine like the dawn of eternal day. All creation will rise to dance and sing the glory of the Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, we pray that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Through Christ our Lord, for by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins, and by his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises without end we acclaim.
Are full of your glory. Oh, so
indeed holy, O Lord, at the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Mitchell our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin. Free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. May the body of Christ be food for our souls and bring us to everlasting life. God's holy gifts for God's holy people, come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Us from harm and mark us as God's beloved ones. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. As the grain of this bread was gathered as one, may we who believe be bound by love. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. As the cup that we share is emptied for all, may we offer up our lives in love. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. When we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we hold in our memory Christ the Lord. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Come now to share the banquet of Christ. Feed on his love with faith and thanksgiving. Know in your heart that he died for you. Thank you.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
We start our seventh round of basket raffle this week. Four more baskets loaded with goodies are displayed in the parish church lobby. The winner's drawing for this round will be Monday, November 23rd at 10 a.m. Tickets for these raffles are $6 for $5. Tickets can be purchased in the church lobby after Mass. Masses for Christmas Eve are 3 p.m., 5 p.m. and 9 p.m. Mass on Christmas Day is at 9 a.m. Social distancing requirements are in force for all Christmas Eve and Christmas Day Masses. Reservations for all Masses, both Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, are absolutely required. No admittance without a reservation. Reservations are now being accepted on a first-come, first-served basis. When we reach attendance capacity for a given Mass, that Mass will be closed to any additional attendees. We have openings remaining, but some of the Masses are close to being full. There is an insert in today's bulletin emphasizing these points and providing additional information pertinent to the Christmas Eve and day Masses. Please read this carefully and completely. Texas Roadhouse Benefit Night is this Thursday, November 19th, starting at 3:30 p.m. St. John's earns 10% of the sales from that evening when a coupon is used. Coupons are available after Mass. There are no weekday Masses this week, nor exposition on Wednesday. We anticipate the normal schedule to resume Saturday, November 21st, when Father Rich returns.
Thank you very much. It was my honor to be here with you this evening to celebrate this Holy Mass. I understand like over 30 priests are quarantining this week and last week, I think. He's just one of many that are out there. It all seemed to kind of happen all at once, these guys. So we're just trying to be safe, and hopefully he'll be back soon. Hopefully I won't have to look for help for my place. We have a fish fry at my place on Friday night. You're welcome to come. It's all drive-through, so the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
River of glory, springs of our birth, blood of God's riches, poured on the earth, we are born from the darkness and clothed in the light. We are bathed in the glory of God. Fountain of mercy, grace flowing free, streams of salvation spilling with love from a tree. Riches poured on the earth, we are born from the darkness and clothed in the light, we are bathed in the glory.